Hey folks, now there's been a bit of an issue with a lot of the Model S and X center screens getting and developing a yellow border around it. Well, Tesla claims they have a fix now, which consists of a UV light. And what their claim is that the adhesives in the screen on some of the model years did not properly cure before they were put together or installed. So Tesla is supposedly coming up with some sort of fix that has basically a jig that faces over the screen with UV light to be able to UV cure the adhesives that are in there. Well, number one, in a previous life, I was the chief nitpicking officer at a custom auto shop that did custom paint jobs, custom fabrication, anything you want. And we also used UV cure adhesives quite a bit for certain things, as well as some UV cure paints for some custom jobs. And I have to say, the yellow border around the screen, as if being adhesive that isn't cured enough, I have to call bullshit. The border and the yellowing is something that happens with excessive sunlight, which also happens to have UV in it. And especially where the border is, such as on my Model X screen right here, and let me grab the camera so I can show you. I usually leave it in night mode, and don't really see it too much in night mode. But you can see the border there. Now, my Model S doesn't have it. I've owned my Model S since it was new, and I am religious about putting my sunshades up. Now, the previous owner of my Model X, because I bought this used about 6 months ago, about a week before my daughter was born, did not take as good of care of her Model X, which is now my Model X. I've mitigated a lot of that, understandable, and the price reflected that, and it was an excellent price, so I'm not going to complain. But I highly doubt she used sun visors. Now, I sat in the car on sunny days as the sun was going by, checked it multiple times, and it basically looks like the sun has been cooking the screen. But we are going to try and fix that ourselves. Whether or not Tesla's UV cure works or not, I have not seen anybody report that they've actually had it done. Just that it either worked, or if it didn't, they ended up getting a screen replacement if they were under warranty yet. Now, also in a previous life, I happen to own two nail salons. Long, long time ago, and no, I never did nails myself, just owned them and bankrolled them, basically. But I have a UV adhesive nail cure. So basically, I took the base off. Basically, that sits on the table. The ladies have their nails done, and then they put their hands in there, and the UV light comes on. And on high, this thing takes, at the high setting, it'll stay on for 60 seconds. On the lowest setting, 15 seconds, and if you want low heat mode, because the UV LED, and this is LED, the UV this thing puts out actually will make your hand really warm. Some people don't like it. It's basically like giving your hand a suntan. And you can do a half heat, which actually turns the power level down by 50%. Well, I took this one apart. I defeated the 60-second timer, and once I plug it in, it'll basically stay on continuously. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tape this thing to my screen, and this puts out UVA radiation, which is the same thing we used at my old shop to cure the UV-cured adhesives, such as what are in the screen. And I'm going to leave it go. Now, Tesla, rumor mill has it from people that I know that are employees with Tesla, they say that the Tesla jig takes about 5 hours. I don't know what power level they're using, but we're going to give this a try and see if we can get rid of the border. Now, this does 265 nanometer and 405 nanometer UVA. If that doesn't do anything, I also have a UVB bulb. I don't know why I have it. I don't think I've ever even used it. And I mean the actual bulb, not a nail dryer. And I also have a UVC germicidal bulb that I'm going to give a try as well. So we're going to give that a try. Start with A if it doesn't do anything. I'm going to leave it on for maybe 4 or 5 hours now. Check it right before I pick up the kids from school. 11:28. All right, we got it connected up right now. It's baking the screen with UVA
light, and I'm going to leave that on there for some time. Right now, because the nail dryer is so small, I'm concentrating on the upper right corner of the screen, and I'll just keep working on that side of the screen for now, and we'll see what changes, or if anything, and if it works, I'll just move on to another quarter of the screen. So it looks like, you know, maybe Tesla's jig, if their UV does work, having the jig will be nice because it will do the whole screen at one time. But I'm not spending anything on here, and I already borrowed the nail dryer from my sister, so I gotta give it back after I, of course, fix it. We'll check back. So the UVA light was going for about 3.5 to 4 hours. I was checking on it every about 15 to 20 minutes, and then I noticed it stopped working, and this thing was very hot, so it looks like I burned out my sister's UV nail dryer. Yeah. So, let's see. What did it do in about 3.5 to 4 hours? Zoom in might be better. It did nothing. In fact, if anything, it might look worse. Although I can't substantiate that. But, focus, did nothing. Now, I was going to switch it with the UVB lamp next. Turns out that my UVB lamp bulb is DOA. I've actually never used it, so I screwed it in and gave it a whirl, and nothing happened. So I have my UVC lamp right there. I use it for sanitizing the house, especially after kids get sick. So that is going to go, and I'm going to put that right on the top corner there. Now, I went online and spent about an hour and a half doing research on UV, or on adhesive for touchscreen displays, and this thing actually should have been correct. What I was finding for information for adhesives for the layers of UV or of touchscreen displays is 365 to 405 nanometers. So this thing is exactly the correct output for this. And they're not baking these screens in factory for 4 or 5 hours. UV lacquer. I mean, this thing's. Before I opened it up and put some jumper cable so it would run continuously, it would dry nail lacquer in about 60 seconds, or less than 60 seconds, but the timer says 60 seconds. So at least 60 seconds or less, you're talking to dry a set of nails. You might see those little pens, glue pens, that use the, have the little UV light on the end of it. Those take about 10 seconds for that UV-cured adhesive that come in those little repair pens, you know, the As Seen on TV crap. Those take about 10 seconds to cure rock hard. So that's a bunch of crap. Okay, so next, plug in. Now, so, like I said, my UVB is broken. This is UVC. And I am going to open my car door because I'm not sticking around. I'm going to come back with some more foil to put over it. I'm just going to leave it up like that. This car is going to smell like ozone. So, on. So, yes, it is, in fact, UVC. I'm not looking at it. I'm getting out. And I'm going to let that run for about... We'll see once it gets dark tonight what we got. So I'm getting out of here. As you can see by the dark backup camera, it is nighttime out. There's Gino. Hi, Gene.
Hi.
So the UVC lamp has been on for, it's 8:30 now, so it's been on for 6 hours. And I'm hesitant to leave it on any longer because that's UVC. And that will really start UV... That will really start UV deteriorating the interior of the vehicle. I don't want to... That's why you put UV protectants on seats and whatnot. But, yeah.
Now, to sterilize a room, I only usually leave this on for like 5 minutes, so pretty much the interior, at least the front interior of this car, is sanitized. But look at that border. No difference whatsoever. So again, my theory is that it's nothing to do with the adhesive. This is, to me, is a bullshit excuse to, or some way to just keep the masses quiet for another quarter. This is screen gate. There's also currently going on charge gate, which is the artificial limiting of supercharging speeds for older vehicles. And there's also a battery gate, where Tesla has artificially lowered the capacity of older 60 and 85 kilowatt hour battery packs, or vehicles that use those battery packs, such as limited 70s that might have been using 85 pack. I mean, I can get into all the different configurations, but on those, Tesla limited the maximum voltage of the vehicle, knocking an easy 10 kilowatt, excuse me, kilowatt hour of capacity off the vehicles. Yeah, so love the cars, but the company is quickly pissing myself and many owners off. Yeah, but look at that. Yeah, not one bit of difference. Now, again, my theory is because the whole bezel around the screens, aluminum, light shining in through the window on the right, on the left. It's about that lighting. I'm going to turn the screen brightness down. I'm going blind here. And what is happening is that's reflecting off here, kind of working like the water bottle thing in the cup holder, you know, where the light comes in, shines through a water bottle, focuses, and starts burning. I have a theory that that is what the problem is. Although I have seen this yellow border on iPhones. My wife's old 5S has this border, and my old 5S is developing it too, but you know, 5S is, I don't know, 6 years old at this point. 5-6 years old, something like that. What are your thoughts? What are your comments? Put them in the the comment box below. Have you had the fix done on your vehicle? Has Tesla performed it on your vehicle? Let me know. Did it work, or did they just end up replacing your screen? Tesla claims this is just cosmetic. I don't know. If we start seeing burned out pixels, then it's definitely not cosmetic. Let's see if I can macro this in there. Focus you. Keep this family. Yep, so I guess I'll try again with the Tesla fix, but I've tried UVC or UVA radiation, or light radiation, and yeah, it did nothing. So UVA and UVC, I like UVB, but as far as I can read everywhere online, UVB and C are not really used for adhesive curing, just UVA. And I sure used that, and 3 hours should have been enough. I know Tesla does like 5, but if they're doing 5, and that little thing does put out, if you put your hand under there, after 60 seconds, your hand is baking just with the light from these LEDs. So I don't know what to tell you guys. Again, comment below. Don't forget, like, and subscribe. Adios.